Hello, everybody. This is Pocono, Legacy Pocono, with the IR18. We are going for a second time around. Last time I tried to do this, we wrecked in the tunnel turn, so I will show that now. Oh, there's contact on the straightaway up ahead of us. Oh, no. Okay. Yep, that's our race. Alright, so here's a wreck from our view. We go into turn one as we got these guys talking. Yeah, that guy just kind of gets hit, and we're checking up, but we didn't check up good enough there, and I think we're the only one out. But no, those guys on the inside are catching the grass and stuff, but yeah, I think we're the dead last car for the race. Alright, here's the view. The three car going in the tri-oval kind of goes down in here and gets hit in the left rear quarter panel. Yep, that's just unfortunate. So yes, our race ended super early, and I just had kind of two frustrating races in a row with IndyCars. I had this race at Pocono, and I had a bad race at Richmond, both of which I don't have videos on. But in general, I kind of had to sit down with kind of how I was racing in the Fix series and kind of realized I was being over-aggressive in the last two races that I did not upload here. Yeah, I just was racing like a complete tool at Homestead, and then really focused on maintaining position at Gateway, which kind of led to me getting screwed over in the race. But yeah, we're gonna try to be smart and focused on what we need to be doing here, but this is very much a pack race, so we're very much at the mercy of the field. Alrighty, so getting ready to go here. Forgot to mention we are the number 10 car, so top 10 means a good finish for us. Oh. That was scary. Well, we survived that. We're gonna line up here for the next restart, and wow, I can't believe that happened. Alrighty, so getting ready for the green here. It looks like in that crash we had four cars definitely out of the race, but it looks like we got at least two other ones that are kind of struggling a little bit on damage. Little brake touch for security there, just to make sure that we're good. I know we go green. I mean, I'm not gonna take it out of mix one because there's really no reason to. I think I got damaged when he touched the wall. Now, we do have like a bit of a front pack here between it looks like 8th and 10th or 9th and 10th. To be honest, when I started doing the IndyCar stuff, like, before I even really, like, got on iRacing, this is what I thought all the races were gonna be like, because everything I saw with IndyCars looked like this. All right, I feel like I need to get by Pierre. I'm like concentrating so hard right now. That's a lapper that's in front of us now, too. I'm tempted to pit. No, we're not pitting with him. Adding a little bit of fuel. Right here. Oh, right in the hump too. Okay.
That's it. Go. Be mindful. You only have 1 minute of time to make. Yeah.
I want to catch these lappers really quickly. Oh man, that guy like tried to chop the fucking leader. I feel like there's some unknown beef here that I'm being witness to. I'm surprised my car is okay after that. At least I think it's okay. Alright, yeah, we screwed that up. I'd rather pull up the one car and just have it be a little top five shootout. A top four shootout. A top five shootout.
Yeah,
I'm pretty sure we've got some sort of damage on the car. I mean, there's no way I can just hit the wall, get a 2x, and the car is like, no, you're fine. Did not mean to shift into sick pit there. Yeah, we're down on top speed because we can't hit 230. Worry about maintaining momentum here. I need him just to pull me away from him. That's all I want. I'll take fourth. Yeah, see here, we hit 228. Oh, you can kind of hit 230. Okay, never mind. The car definitely feels different from that hit. Oh, there's gonna be a wreck in the back, I think. Please don't be a caution. Please stay green. Actually, we won't get a restart, so a caution wouldn't matter. Actually, we kind of want it to stay green, because if we get stay green, it might they might crash up in front of us. Alright, we might whiz forth here. Yep, he's gaining. Okay. Alright, so here's the start crash. We saw this coming up here. This guy's going straight. I think he kind of comes up a little bit, but yeah, those two get together. And they got multiple cars. There's at least four involved there. There's spinners in the back. That guy gets clobbered. Alright, here is the accident I thought was going to be a caution because I saw this on my map. The 11 cars on the outside, they make contact, and then... Yep, just kind of get spun there. I mean, it looks like they came down and the other car came up, so not too much. You could sit there and say maybe it was retaliation, but really it wasn't. Might have been, but, you know, not very clear-cut. Alright, so here's a last lap from our perspective. Get the draft, we go under, they go high. We kind of stay in that middle lane. Yeah, we just drift up a little bit. I didn't feel like I was drifting up too much there. And there goes three cars that were for position. Alright, here's their perspective. They run high. Yeah, that looks really bad from that perspective. Okay, so from here, you can kind of just see the trajectory out to the wall. And I mean, I'm starting to go straight there. And I mean, I would have plowed the wall if... I kept it stuck. I don't know if it's because I reacted to them kind of cutting down a little bit more, or if it was just me being tight and kind of the car not gripping as much as it was, but yeah, that was my bad. But you know, that's one of those things where I'm still trying to like figure out how to race these, and that's one of those corners where you're really on edge trying to get it to grip. And yeah, I just completely screwed that up and threw away at the minimum a top five, just kind of screwed that up. Alright, so you can see here, we only lose a little bit of SR. We gained some IR back. Yeah, we could have gained a little bit more if we placed higher, but we didn't. Yeah, fifth maybe would have been where we would have finished, but yeah, not the greatest last lap there. You see down here at the bottom, there's the three cars that were taken out lap one. I think this guy, too, was kind of screwed up in the accident and kind of was sitting repairing stuff. Yeah, so we finish P8. That spin on the last lap. That was pretty interesting though with the strategy. Kind of the field kind of broken up there. I just was trying to stay with that lead pack, but when I smacked the wall, that pretty much screwed my laps up. I had damage to some degree. I don't know what it was, but it was definitely slowing the car down. Didn't feel like it was spooling the momentum that it did previous. Still doesn't take away the pretty stupid move there, but yeah, hopefully y'all enjoyed that. I know that last lap was pretty dumb, but yeah, it sucks just kind of being in that position where you don't really feel like you have a fair shot with the car because you got damaged. And yeah, the car is just not turning. So yeah, dumb mistake. But hopefully y'all enjoyed that. Y'all have a good rest of your week and peace.